Hello viewers, this is P5G41 CMLX. This board supports Intel dual core or core studio with socket 775 technology, and you can use DDR2 DDR3 memory, either this or that. You can use either DDR3 or DDR2. Some viewers requested to upload the videos with English language, but I am not very strong with English, so I will try my best. Okay, so now I am going to check the standby voltages are stable, the standby voltages are present or not. The SMPS pin number 9 and pin number 16 contains 5 volt. The pin number 16 is PS on, pin number 9 is 5 volt standby. So this is pin number 16, which is in green color wire. So I can get my 5 volt, right? And now I tried with purple color. Yes, of course I am getting 5.24. You just notice one thing. 5 volt standby is always a little greater than 5 volt PS on. Now this is standby 5.24 volt, and now I am changed it to green color wire, which means my PS on, this is 5.22. okay, so this is 5.22. The pin number 16 has been denoted by 5 volt standby. This happens inside my SMPS. 5 volt standby connected through the resistor, and this is also 5 volt. So 5 volt standby is always a little greater, and this 5 volt standby connected through the resistor to PS on, this will be always little lesser with compared to standby voltage. Okay, so this is my standby voltage, and the resistors connected in between this and this. So pin number 9 and pin number 16, 20. Pin number 9 and pin number 16, I'm sorry. So this is 5.22. Okay, now in this motherboard we are having dead. Okay, now when I am triggering my computer, nothing will happen, but the standby LED is constant. So now I am checking my switch voltage, 0.31. So there is no step down voltage. Okay, standby is stable, but there is no step down voltage. So I don't have any short in 5 volt power plane or 3.3 volt power plane. If I have any short or any burnt component, then this voltage will not be stable. Okay, so I don't have any short. So the 5.24 is stable now. And switch, I don't have any voltage. This is 0.31. So this indicates there is no step down in this motherboard. This 5 volt stepping down into 3.3 volt, but this will not happen. And one more thing, this motherboard does not contain any short circuit. Okay, so now I am going to check B10 of PCI Express. No, the same thing. No, this is 0.31. You just notice the value 0.31, the same value present on my switch side, which means this is the receiver, and also the switch is also the receiver, both are connected in single line. And where is the denoter? We are going to find out where is the denoter. The denoter named as LDO regulator. This is auto adjustable technology. Okay, we are not going to give any gate voltage. When you are giving 5 volt, then you are getting automatically 3.3 volt. Now I am going to find out where is my step down regulator. So I am going to change my multimeter into continuity mode. Now I am going to fix one probe at B10. Fine. Yes, this is B10. Now I am going to check where is my LDO regulator. Normally the LDO regulator placed either this point or in between the PCI or PCI Express slot. Okay, so I am not ready to waste your time. So now directly I am going to the LDO regulator output. When you are tracing the continuity, please turn it on your, turn off your power supply unit. Yes, so the B10 is directly connected with this regulator. So this is the output. Okay, this is the output. You can see this regulator. This regulator looks like this. This regulator looks like this. So this point is output point. This is the input point. Okay, this is the drive, auto adjustable drive. So this is the input point. Now I am checking whether this regulator receives 5 volt or not. Because this input side is connected with, now I am checking the input side with, okay. So this 5 volt coming, this 5 volt coming to this LDO regulator, this LDO regulator steps down this 5 volt into 3.3 volt. This 3.3 volt goes to my power switch and also my PCI Express slot. You can check this 3.3 volt at IO connector nearby. You can check this 3.3 volt at LAN IC. You can check this 3.3 volt at your battery, I mean CMOS section, RTC section, and also you can check this 3.3 volt at your ICH and power switch. This is the very important 3.3 volt. Now this voltage is not present on this motherboard. Okay, so fine. Now I am going to fix my multimeter with volt mode. Let's check whether 5 volt present or not. Yes, it's not stable. It is not stable. And 3.3 volt is also not stable. But what about the 5 volt? Yes, it's clear. No. No, the 5 volt is also gone now. Just before testing this LDO regulator, we are having this 5 volt. Yes, it's present. It's present. Now I am checking the pad, it's present 5 volt. Now I am checking the output side. The output is absolutely 0.3 volt, which means we don't have 3.3 volt. This point must contain 3.3 volt. This has been done by this LDO regulator. This is the LDO regulator. This is the data sheet of LDO regulator. Okay, when you are giving 3.3 volt at this side, when you are giving 3.3 volt at this side, this LDO regulator deliver when you are giving 5 volt at this side, this LDO regulator delivers 3.3 volt as its output, and this is the adjustable gate. So this gate will not driven by any other component or any other section. This is the auto adjustable gate. This is the part number of this LDO regulator is APU1084. Every motherboard contains two LDO regulators. One is for ICH and another one is for common 3.3 volt. The ICH LDO regulator contains 3.3 volt at 3 ampere. By the same way, this APU1084, which means the common 3.3 volt contains 3.3 volt at 5 ampere. Okay, the 3.3 volt output with 5 ampere. Now we are going to replace the LDO regulator with the same port number. Okay, let's wait. I am going to remove this LDO regulator. Be sure about your power supply. Flux must for this works. Flux roll is very very important to save your motherboard. Please unplug your power supply. And always use some mask or kerchief when you are doing this work, because you must now I am replacing this LDO regulator. Okay, the work has been done. Okay, you must use some kerchief or you must use some mask, because if you are using the flux with halogen free, then you don't need to wear anything, but local paste or soldering flux or contains the halogen, so please wear some kerchief or mask when you are doing this. Now I am waiting for the room temperature. Please do not connect your SMPS now. This is the removed one. Let's wait. Now I am going to check whether I have completed the work good or bad. Okay, if it is good, then there will be the good contact. If it is good, then there will be the good contact between the board and the component. Okay, the negative probe I am going to fix at the component in, and the positive probe, this must be very important. This will be very important when you are replacing the BIOS IC in your motherboard, when you are replacing the LM324 in your motherboard. Okay, this is very very important. Before giving the power supply, you have to check this. With continuity mode, it should buzzer now. If it's so, then good. Now the contact between the component and the motherboard is ensured. It's confirmed. Great. Now I can give my power supply. Let's wait for 1 minute. So now you know what is LDO regulator, and you can easily find out this LDO regulator. There are so many things before you removing this regulator, because the motherboard contains any short then this LDO regulator will not deliver the output voltage. So before removing this LDO, you have to confirm, you have to ensure the motherboard does not contain any short circuit in 5 volt power plane and also 3.3 volt power plane. Okay. Both are very large. Before pressing power button, this 5 volt and 3.3 volt spread across the entire motherboard. Okay. Now this is the time to plug in our power supply. Let's check whether the voltage is present or not now. Let's check the voltage. I am going to fix my negative probe in ground and 20 volt to DC. Yes. Whether the 5 volt is stable or not, it's stable. Is it receives 5 volt now? Yes, it receives. Is it deliver 3.3 volt or not? Yes, it delivers. Whether it is present on my PCI Express B10? No. Yes, it's present, 3.4 volt. Now I am going to check my power switch. This is my power switch. Okay, this is my power switch. Yes, it contains 3.4 volt. Okay, 3.4 volt. And also my I/O controller. Let's check with the I/O controller. It must be either 5 volt or 3.3 volt. The I/O required, the operational voltage. The voltage will be either 5 volt or 3.3 volt. It is before pressing power button. Yes, it's 3.3 volt. Okay, this is the standby voltage. The same value which we are having at our power switch and also B10 of PCI Express slot. Okay, 3.41. Now we are checking. Yes, it's 3.41. So I/O control required the operational voltage. This is the only voltage for I/O controller. The PCH is going to receive so many voltages after pressing the power button. The GMCH is going to receive so many voltages after pressing power button. CPU is going to receive 3 different voltages after pressing power button, but the I/O controller required only one voltage. Either it is 5 volt or 3.3 volt. This I/O required 3.3 volt. Okay, fine. Now let's turn on the motherboard. Yes, it's spinning. The SMPS is spinning. I'm waiting for the buzzer sound. No, I am not connecting my core supply. Now, yeah, it has been connected. Now let's check and let's wait for the error sound. The buzzer connected. So if the motherboard is good, then we are getting the buzzer sound. Yes, it has been fixed. Okay, now I am going to fix my RAM into the slot. Before fixing the RAM, I just want to tell one thing. This motherboard is okay now. Okay, before continue with my fixing my RAM, before we are going to see the display, I just want to tell you one thing over here, because this is the rare motherboard which contains the DDR2 RAM as well as the DDR3 RAM. Okay, so what we are going to check with this, this is the LDO, this is the RAM regulator, this is the RAM regulator, this is the only regulator which is going to deliver 1.8 volt when you are fixing DDR2 and 1.5 volt when you are fixing DDR3. If you are fixing DDR2 and DDR3 at the same time in this motherboard, the board will not function. Okay, so this is going to change the output value automatically. This is the upper MOSFET and lower MOSFET of RAM voltage. Okay, this is the upper MOSFET and lower MOSFET. These two MOSFETs are driven by the regulator, the RAM IC or the RAM regulator, whatever it is. The RAM, the upper MOSFET connected with the pin number 2 and the lower MOSFET connected with the pin number 4. Pin number 3 is normally ground for this regulator. And now we are going to check the output voltage with both DDR2 and DDR3. Okay, now I am going to fix my DDR2 RAM. This is transient 2GB DDR2. Let's check the voltage. The blue one is DDR2 slot and the black one is DDR3 slot. Right, fixed. Multimeter is in volt mode. Okay, multimeter is in volt mode. Now fine, now let's check what will be the output voltage. Standby. Okay, motherboard triggered. Okay, now I am checking the output voltage. It's should be 1.8. Okay, it should be 1.8, not 1.5, it should be 1.8. Okay, now I am turning off my computer and again turning on. Okay, I'm not going to remove my probe from this point. Okay, so now I am going to trigger my computer with tweezers. Check the voltage. This is a DDR2 now. The motherboard is in DDR2 mode. Yes, it's turned on. Let's wait. Fine, this is automatically changed to 1.8 volt. Okay, now I am going to fix my DDR3 RAM. It has been removed and this is DDR3. Yeah, this is a DDR3. Okay, 2GB DDR3. Now I am going to fix this at my black. Fine. Again, the probe fixed at the same place. I'm not going to change anything. Okay, the RAM has been changed. That's all. The RAM is now DDR3. Now let's check the output voltage. Boot trigger. It's 1.5, and it is not going to change from 1.5 to 1.8. because we are fixing the DDR3 RAM and board is initiated now. The board is initiated now. It's turned on now. The voltage is 1.5 volt when I am fixing the DDR2 at the DDR2 slot. The same regulator is going to, that is the point. Okay, and there are so many theory behind this. Okay, there are so many theory behind this technology. Now I am going to trigger my board. Yes, the 1.5 will become 1.8 within a moment. That's all. Okay, within a moment the board is turned on now. The board is clearly turned on now. See, you can see the display. Okay, the board is turned on. Now let's check what is happening on this RAM section. Okay, this RAM regulator is common for DDR2, DDR3 and also DDR1. Okay, this RAM regulator is common. So this is the RAM regulator. This is the upper MOSFET. This is lower MOSFET. The lower MOSFET connected with the ground. The upper MOSFET connected with the standby voltage 5 volt. This is pin number 2. This is pin number 4. And this is pin number 3. Supply, the same supply given to the RAM regulator. Okay, this RAM regulator changes the value with the output. This is the output voltage and this is your RAM slot. This is a dim slot 1, this is a dim slot 2. And we are giving the feedback from this point. Okay, this is the feedback, this is RAM enable, which is coming from 4 different places. Okay, this is S5, S3, PS on, 5 is standby. This is the enable section. From this enable section, this regulator has been activated. After activating this regulator, voltage delivered. Okay, what will happen? When I am triggering my computer, it delivers only 1.5 volt. After fuse again, it has been changed to 1.8 volt. This happens depends on the feedback. Okay, this depends on the feedback to the RAM regulator. Okay, so this is the technology. We are getting 1.5 volt as well as 1.8 volt from the same regulator. Okay, only the same regulator. So we can change this regulator with the DDR2 motherboard or DDR1 motherboard. All we have to check only one thing, whether the pin number 3 is grounded or not. Okay, now this motherboard is working good. After replacing the LDO regulator from this place. Thank you for watching my video. Good day.